more of. Why else do I want to see independence? We have to get rid of Trident. This is an absolute... absolutely obscene waste of money.
Yeah, a waste of money. And while we're on the subject of waste of money, there was a certain funeral recently.
Many people have talked about her role on the global stage or the national stage. I was to talk about the woman who represented Finchley for 33 years. The woman my party members remember never, ever as Maggie, but simply as Mrs. T, or more fondly, as our Margaret. From the outset, Finchley Conservatives knew they had a winner.
Figure. She was a towering global figure who made a vast impact. And you know, her reputation is rightly immensely high.
She was a remarkable Prime Minister, and she did some extraordinary things. In many ways, she was exactly the right Prime Minister for the time she achieved that office. And I think as a result of that and what she did, we owe her a great deal.
The revolutionary, and she was a liberator. She freed millions of people to buy their own homes, to buy shares in British companies.
At the heart of her approach was her instinctive understanding that the restoration of prosperity depended on supply-side reform.
Yeah, yeah, we gotta get out of this place. If it's the last thing we ever do, we gotta get out of this place. Girl, there's a better life for me and you.
The kind of economics that she inflicted on the world has, of course, broadened and deepened since she was around. I'd like to do just one more serious bit before I finish up here, and this is part of a speech by Noam Chomsky in which he outlines the problems of this. This is from a few years ago, but everything he said is still valid and in fact has worsened since then. I think it helps to explain the importance of keeping things like International Workers' Day going, because it helps to create consciousness of these kinds of problems. Speaking of consciousness, maybe this is one that passed you by, but the United Kingdom government, the current lot, actually want to get rid of International Workers' Day, or May Day, in England and Wales. They've proposed moving it to St George's Day in England and St David's Day in Wales, so there's government solidarity with the workers for you. So here's Noam Chomsky.
These are among the huge mechanisms of social policy that are used to ensure that the pampered Western workers have to give up their luxurious lifestyles. And the effects are pretty dramatic. One effect is just a vast move towards a kind of totalitarian system in which highly concentrated, unaccountable private power determines what goes on. Nobody has a word to say about it, and for the most part, nobody knows anything about it. And the effects are very obvious just in the numbers. Every year Fortune magazine comes out with a big thing on the Fortune 500. This year is a particularly interesting one because this is the 40th anniversary, so a big celebration of the Fortune 500. The May 15th issue is worth looking at. I don't know if you recall, but some years back, Abby Hoffman wrote a book called Steal This Book, and that's what you ought to do with a Fortune 500. Don't pay them $4.50 for it or whatever it costs. But if you can pick it up somewhere, it's worth looking at. Very big, fat, glossy volume, which is quite intriguing. In the last years, for 1994, which discussed 1993, they described 1993 as a dazzling year for corporate profits, even though sales growth was stagnant. So, you know, not selling anything, but they're making huge amounts of money. 1994 was far better. They say profits went up a stunning 54% on a sales growth of 8% and employee growth of 2.6%. You just listen to those numbers and you see a lot about the world. Profits up a stunning 54%, sales growth 8%, meaning virtually no change, and employee growth 2.6%. You know, that doesn't exist. The numbers are revealing, and they mean something. And concentration has gone up, too. The Fortune 500 now controls 63% of the total U.S. gross domestic product. Now, that's a level of totalitarianism that's, remember, these are totalitarian institutions, as totalitarian as human beings have ever devised. And that's a level of totalitarian control that has very rarely been reached in the world, if ever, you might check. Among the biggest gainers are Manpower Incorporated, which hires temporary workers. Very important fact. They're now number, their profits were up 35% last year, sales up 35%, what they call sales, meaning selling people, was up 30% to undermine pampered Western workers, remember, because they're selling temporary workers, so you don't need benefits and you don't need security, you get a flexible labor market. So their sales are up 35%. They're now number 237 in the combined industry services list. Services doesn't mean guys who clean the, you know, the offices. It means investment firms and banks and, you know, those guys. They're 237. Kelly, their sales are up 21%. Well, that also tells you something. These are another form of the techniques for undermining the workforce. And the workforce means the population. You know, workers means most of the population, their families, their children, and so on. Caterpillar is now number 61 in this combined industrial service list. Its profits were up 46% from 1993, and the earnings per share were up 46%. That's not small. And this is expected to continue. The May 1st issue of Fortune has a big article called Why Profits Will Keep Booming. Remember, 1993, they were dazzling, and they were even more splendid in 1994, they put it. That's the fourth successive year of double-digit growth in profits, and they expect it to go on through 1996 at least. Remember, this is a period when wages are going down and working hours are going up, okay? But profits are just dazzling. Earnings per share, they say, have doubled since 1991. The return on capital has more than doubled, considerably more than doubled, since 1980. Profit margins are up. Working hours are up. Temporary workers are way up as a proportion of the workforce. The only thing that's down is wages and benefits and working conditions. Other things are up, too, as I mentioned before, like industrial accidents have shot way up. So, you know, a lot of things are doing really good. But some things aren't doing so good, namely the pampered Western workers with their luxurious lifestyles. The Wall Street Journal, having hailed the welcome development of transcendent importance in 1992, noticed another one just a few weeks ago. They said that in 1993, the change in unit labor costs finally reached zero. There's always inflation, remember. Finally reached zero. And that stayed there since 1993. Well, it's another welcome development of transcendent importance. In fact, total labor costs last year were lower than any year since 1981. A headline reads, economic gains fail to increase benefits wages, which kind of understates it.
Okay, so that's it for this International Workers' Day special, and I hope you've enjoyed it.
To enemies. Recognize my friend, everybody ought to stand up and be counted. Peace and freedom is my goal. Peace and freedom is my goal. Yes, it is. Here's what we got to do, listen. We got to stamp out poverty and end all of the misery.
Put an end to all the unjust war. Now we know what we are fighting for.
Reinforce and disregard the Constitution. Then we can clean up all the mind pollution.